On a previous webinar, we talked about keyboard shortcuts and other little tricks you can do very quickly. Today, we're going to take something that's a little bit bigger chunk using styles in Word. But if you just take a few minutes to really kind of understand the concept, it can exponentially save so much more time and sweat while you're dealing with Word documents. I know this from personal experience because I've worked with Word for years. I didn't start using styles till I was, at Office for about 3 years. So anyone can learn this stuff really quick, and it will save a lot of time. I'm going to go over here to a Word document, and this is going to be an unformatted document here. You just see in a second. One thing I want to throw out there, there's a mantra I kind of use. I think it's attributed to Stephen King, who says, don't get it right, get it written. Here's another thing. Don't get it formatted, get it written. Work on formatting your document afterwards. It's a little tough if you come from the old typewriter age or if you're a kid, I know, because I have a couple teenagers. As soon as they click this thing and they look at fonts, they're gone for 5 minutes, right? But I'm going to show you the advantages of doing that. So here we have a unformatted document about the solar system. And here's what I would normally do if I didn't know about styles. I might take my title here and, okay, I want to center that and okay, I'll make it big. I don't know how big. I guess that looks good. Here's my author thing, and I'm going to try to center that, and I'll make that a little smaller, I guess. And okay, now I have all these headings. What should I do for a heading? Well, let's make it a color. I like colors. So let's kind of, I don't know about that. Let's make that a little bigger. I don't know, 16 font? Point font, maybe. Oh, with some spacing. I could do a carriage return. Carriage returns are bad, especially if you're continually typing because now you're in that font. That's bad. So let's get away from the carriage return and maybe you know about, spacing. If you go up to the paragraph in the ribbon here in this little triangle in the bottom right-hand corner, that will open your paragraph settings. And after, I'm going to put a little 6 point, sure. I don't know what that is, sure. Okay, that gives me a little spacing. Now, if I have to do this for each of my headings, I know about Format Painter. So I can take this format, go over up here to Format Painter in the ribbon, click on that, and now everything I touch will be painted like that. Oops. So that's cool. I can do that. But if I'm doing that for a lot of headings, I have to go through my entire document. That can be kind of troublesome. I can do all those steps, change font, change spacing, change color with headings. I'm going to go up here to the quick styles, which is up here in the ribbon, and the planets here, I'm going to hit heading 1, and it's just given me some spacing. It's changed the font. It's changed the color. Kind of what I just did there with 3 steps I can do with styles. So let me click asteroids and hit heading 1 again. So I can go through my document this way. Now, the planets, that's going to be a different heading. So I can do heading 2. And I don't have to worry about, well, a 16-point font for the heading 1. What should this be 14-point font? Should it be a different color? I don't have to worry about that. I can just go through my document and choose the heading. So here's a planet. That's going to be, oops, I hit something on the ribbon here. Heading 2. The Earth is heading 2. Now, the moons, that will be another part. That's going to be heading 3. So you get the idea here. So Mars is heading 2, and then Phoebus and Deimos, which are the moons of Mars, they will have heading 3. So I can go through the document that way and set everything up. And there's several reasons why I'm going to do that. I'm going to show you that. One is, of course, the look. Now, let's say I don't like this look of this third heading. To me, Mars, the heading 2 of Mars and the heading 3 of the moons doesn't look different enough. Let's say I want to change color on this. So I'm going to change the color. I'm going to make that, I don't know, let's say red, so it looks distinct. Okay, I like that. Now I can change the headings for all of those automatically. I'm going to highlight this heading, heading 3, and I'm going up to the ribbon now. I'm going to right-click on the heading 3 button, and it's going to give me a menu, including update heading. So I'm going to click that. And now Deimos has changed, and anything that was a heading 3 from now on, or anything I've made as a heading 3, like the Earth's moon back here, I'm going to rotate that back. That's now red because I've changed the heading 3 on this. And I can do that for any of these other ones. Let's go up to the top of the document really quick. And this title, the solar system, there's actually a title style here. I'm going to hit that. And this other one for here, the Doug Thomas, look at all the quick styles I have here. I'm going to go to the little arrow here on the right-hand side. And there's a whole bunch of them. Now, there's nothing that says author, but I can pick any of these. And as you see, as I mouse over them, I can get different looks. And as you can see, I can edit it later if I need to. Let's just pick this one for now, this intense quote. But what it doesn't matter is the headings are going to be different from the rest of the quick styles, and I'll show you that in just a second also. So I'm formatting my document. Now notice the sun is still the old formatting. I haven't changed that. If I want to change the overall look, I don't like blue, I don't like this stuff, I can do that easily. I'm going to go up to the design part of the tab now. And you can see that all these things pop up in the ribbon that are called style sets. And this gives me different looks. And I'm just mouse over here and I can see different looks on the screen. Here's one that's for that gives a numbering system. So if you have a legal document or a long document, you can do this whole numbering system, you know, 1.1, 2.1, stuff like that. That does it automatically for you. So that's kind of nice. And then there's some more informal styles here. And again, notice the sun is not changed. The sun has not changed. The sun has not changed these different looks because I didn't format that yet as a heading. I just did that old formatting. That's why that's not changing like the other headings are. So let me click this one. And again, you can augment this to your heart's content. There's color changes. If you want a different color set here, I want to do something a little more purplish. Ooh, let's turn in the report with that color. You can change all of that there. There's also different ways to change with themes. Themes are even bigger than style sets. You think about them as PowerPoint, but you can use them here in Word. And I can just mouse over, and I get a whole different font set. Look at this one here. This was called Main Event. Really dark and foreboding. That's a little hard to read. I'm going to pick this one here. And I'll change. And then each of those style sets change within the theme. So lots of different ways to format, but everything changes together instead of me going through and having to fiddle with each heading. Okay, let me, what I'm going to do is let me close this document and show you some other things about styles that are worth keeping up. I'll pull the cake out of the oven here, and I have a formatted document with a different theme and a different style set, but the same document about the solar system. I'm going to scroll down here to the bottom here and just finish up. I haven't finished writing this, but I have a couple of the planets I need to work on. Uranus or Uranus, pick your, you know, if you want to giggle, that's why people call your teachers call it Uranus, so kids won't giggle, or adults. So I'm going to hit the control key and any of the planets I have here. Now I'm going to, I can grab them. I'm going to turn those into heading 2 and then my mouse doesn't seem to want to work in here. Okay. I may have to do this manually here. And so here are the moons. I'm going to make those. I'm holding the control key down and clicking them, and that'll be heading 3. And then here's another section on the dwarf planets. I'm going to do heading 1 on that. And then all these things here will be. And I can choose any heading I want to. I'm going to make these heading 3. So you don't have to go in that order of 1, 2, 3. But making things headings are important. And I'll show you here why. Let's go up to the top of the document. And I'm going to make an instant table of contents. So I'm going to put my mouse on a blank line. I could do it on a totally blank page. I'm going to go over to the reference section. I'm going to click that. And on the left-hand side is table of contents. There's some pre-built automatic table of contents, and I can just click on it, and boom, like that. Boom, like that. I've made a table of contents. It's only picking up the headings. So the title is not there, the author, which was that, the style was called an intense quote. It only picks up anything that's a heading. Now, this is a big table of contents for a small paper, and I can change that quickly. Let me go back into table of contents and scroll down. And there's a custom table of contents there. Now you can customize to your heart's content, but the main area here is this, how many levels of headings? I have 3 heading levels, 1, 2, and 3. You can have as many as you want, I think. You can make bigger, more headings if you need to. But I'm gonna change this to 2. So I only want headings 1 and headings 2 to show up in my table of contents. Do I wanna update my table? Yes. And now there's a nice table of contents that's just showing heading ones, which is the sun, asteroids, the planets, and dwarf planets, and the heading two, the planets. Also, this is hyperlinked. So if you have an electronic document, you hand it in, you want to go to page 6 immediately, control click, and it takes you right down to page 6. So again, think of this as a long, long document, a 50-page manuscript or legal documents or contracts. You can really get around quickly with that. Another thing that you can do, and this started with Word 2010, is the navigation pane. Let's go show you that. You go to the View tab and click Navigation Pane Box. And on the left-hand side of your document, all those headings appear. Again, just headings appear. Anything else that you style in a different type of style won't appear. Just headings will appear. And this is actually kind of your document laid out. Now, let's say you're teacher, who's an astronomy teacher, is also an English teacher, and they want the planets in alphabetical order. One, you should question that. But two, okay, if I had to do that in my regular document, I would have to take Mercury and I'd have to, you know, take this whole thing and make sure I have all the correct, you know, if it goes on two, I have to cut it and then I have to figure out where to put it and scroll down my document and find the right place and then paste it. And you do that for a long document and you pick up the wrong you pick up extra spaces and all that, or here I put in the wrong place. It can get pretty cumbersome very quickly, cutting and pasting to reorganize your document. Let's look over at the navigation pane. And what I can do here is I can drag sections. Okay, so let's do this in alphabetical order. Earth is first, then Jupiter. I'm just going to click on it and then unclick when I have it. And all the moons of Jupiter also appear in this order. So I can quickly make this alphabetized. Neptune. Saturn goes above Venus. UV, Venus is last, but before the dwarf planets. And there, I've quickly organized my document alphabetically, and the whole document here is changed on the side. Now let me go up to the table of contents. The table of contents does not update automatically like a live preview. You have to tell it to update it. It's really easy though. I'm just going to click on the table of contents. You can also do this in the ribbon. And you can click Update Table. You can update just the page numbers. Let's do that. And now you can see Mercury's on page 4, Saturn's on page 6. But I'm going to update the whole table of contents, even in the order. So Update Table, Update Entire Table. And now the planets are in alphabetical order and the table of contents is in that order. So with styles, you can change the look of your document quickly and it's uniform. You can get an instant table of contents and you can organize your document through the navigation pane and change things around very simply. Those are three of the big benefits of using styles. So that kind of wraps up today's webinar. We have references for that video's how-to if you want to learn more about styles. You can go to aka.ms/style123 and you can see those references. We'll get the video of this up a little later this week or early next week. You can find that at the same address, aka.ms/style123. If you want any information about the Office webinar series in general, calendar reminders, see our upcoming schedule, see previous webinars, go to aka.ms/offweb for that. Next week, we'll be actually talking about how to do webinars in Link. If you have Link or if you get the new Office 365 for Business, you'll have Link and you'll be able to create webinars. We're going to show you a little behind the scenes here at the Office Webinar Series. But for today and today's Office Webinar Series, thank you for joining this Office 15-Minute Webinar.